the Tom and the Hawk Show.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Tom and Doug Show. We're here live and we're talking to you. We're saying important things. We come to you every week because we believe in you and we trust you and you. We want you to be a better person.
And we know that you can't do that without proper help. And so this show really makes your life worth living.
That's what it says on our stationery. And we want to make sure that we're doing it every week for you. And your part of that deal is you got to show up here to listen to the show. So today we're going to talk about something really important, and this: how do we mold ourselves into being the right kind of people?
Well, I think the best way is to be easily manipulated.
Manipulation, that's the key.
And so if I tell you, Tom, that you should stand up right now.
Okay, I'm going to stand up right now. Okay.
You are not standing
up. All right, I'll stand up. I was lying. Okay, I'm standing up now.
Okay, now you may sit down.
All right, now I'm sitting down.
See, don't you feel better?
No, not really.
Well, that's because you were trying to do two things at once. You were being manipulated, but you were also lying, which is a manipulation tactic. So you were on both sides of that coin. So you got to stop flip-flopping and just pick one and let me manipulate you so that you can become a better person.
But isn't there an easier way that I can be manipulated that will make me do the right thing without even having to think about it?
Oh, there's so many ways. Let's talk about this for a while.
Eyes like searchlights in the night, gorgeous teeth and snowy white. Take a look, here comes my ball and chain. She's a sunny gem to me, tons of personality. Take a look, here comes my ball and chain. We do a huddle when we hit a chair. How she can cuddle is no one's a bear. Looked around from pole to pole, found her in a sugar bowl. Take a look, here comes my ball and chain.
So we're here and we're talking about the best way that I can be manipulated, because that's going to make me a better person.
Well, the best way, what I call the golden rule of influence, is to try to manipulate you in a way that you don't even know you're being manipulated.
Yeah, that's what I want.
Yeah, and it's magical. First of all, this is how advertising works.
I saw that on the TV.
Well, as seen on TV, there's a great phrase, four words that are absolutely meaningless in reality, right? Because what does it take to get on TV? Just pay the station. right? Give them money and anyone and anything can be on TV. So it's actually absolutely meaningless. But when we hear or see that little red sticker as seen on TV, it brings with it a cachet of, oh, this must be important and good and high quality because it was on TV. Because we love TV so much, that kind of rubs off on anything that uses this slogan.
So I have a number of friends who are now on like dating websites.
Mm-hmm.
They should probably put that in their little profile as seen on TV.
It would work, I bet.
William Dunn, right?
And you don't have to say it was because of, you know, the crime news, right? That you were on TV.
So that's a good way to manipulate me, to say something was on TV, and then all of a sudden it's going to raise in my level of respect for that thing.
Exactly.
Follow your dream. Don't be afraid. It's a universe where anything can happen, and you have so much potential. Follow your dream. You'll be all right if you just follow, follow your dream. And your dream should be practical, and your dream should be smart, and your dream should be something I have approved of from the start. And your dream should be predictable, and your dream should not surprise, and your dream should not bring worry to your dear parents' eyes. So follow your dream. It can be anything I want. Just follow, follow your dream.
Ew, what you got there?
Bear chips.
They're kind of tangy.
Hi, we're back talking about the best ways that we can manipulate me, because I need to be a better person and I need to be manipulated.
Well, yeah, because you're going to do the hard work of becoming a better person all on your own?
Heck no.
See, so you need help. And as your friend, it is my privilege to try to help you this way.
So what's another way that I can be manipulated that would be easy for me? It wouldn't be less work for me.
So there was a great study where they took, you know, groups of 20 or 40 young men, and they brought them into a room with lots of computer terminals, and they gave them surveys on these computers.
It sounds like a great thing to do.
And the surveys were asking them about things, you know, that are pretty stable personality traits, like, you know, what are your deep human values? You know, how much do you care about family or religion, making money, your career, all these different things, right? And we think of those things as pretty stable, that you kind of have figured out what matters to you, and it's not easily going to be pushed around. Wrong.
What?
All they had to do to shift everyone's values was, instead of the room being 20 men, it was 19 men and one woman in among them at one of the computer terminals answering surveys on her own. They didn't interact with her. They didn't get to talk to her. There was no chance they were going to date her. But just having her in the room, all the men's answers changed. They shifted to being more about the importance of money and career.
You know, that's because men assume that women can read their minds.
I don't think. See, that's the thing. If you asked any of these men, were you aware of the other people in the room? Did they influence the way you answered? They're all going to say absolutely not. So, but just because from an evolutionary standpoint, men kind of feel like they're supposed to be the providers and that that's attractive and being confident, that's the way their answer's skewed when you just stuck a woman somewhere near them.
That's mind-blowing. You're telling me that if you round up 40 turkey guys and put them in a little room and ask them what their opinions are, what they value, and then you stick one woman in there, not even talking to them, that it's going to change the way they answer those questions?
Yes.
That is messed up. I hope that was the title of the study. That's messed up.
Scientists aren't usually, they're good at coming up with clever studies. They're not so good at titling them. We should start a consulting service, Tom.
Well, let's do that. We'll listen to this song and we'll see whether we can manipulate ourselves during this song.
All through the day, I me mine, I me mine, I me mine. All through the night, I me mine, I me mine, I me mine. Always frightened of leaving it, everyone's weaving it, coming on strong all the time. All through the day, I me mine. I me mine. I me me mine. I me me mine. I me me mine. All I can hear, I me mine, I me mine, I me mine. Even those tears, I me mine, I me mine, I me mine. No one's frightened of playing it, everyone's saying it, flowing more freely than wine. All through the day, I me mine. I me mine. I me mine. I me mine. I me mine.
We're so sorry. We're back. We're talking about the best ways we can be manipulated.
So one of the things that I loved about my ex-wife was how well she could manipulate me.
Really? Yep. Even though you knew what was going on?
Yes, I often knew what was going on. And yet she did it so well. She was magnificent at it that I didn't really mind. So my favorite example of this, we had just bought a house. We had a young daughter was like one or something like that. And I don't really know much about how to repair houses. I don't like it. I don't like painting. I don't, you know, that's just never been a thing that I really like. So we got the house into perfectly fine shape. And then she's still finding more things she wants to do, right? So she's, you know, like the kitchen was this bright, cheery yellow color and it got morning sun and was just great kind of morning breakfast room, right? And she'd say, I want to paint the kitchen. No, come on. We've been painting everything else. This is beautiful. It's nice and bright and cheery. I like it. Let's not paint it. She'd wait a couple weeks. She'd come back again, say, I was thinking we should paint the kitchen. What? No, I don't want to do that. I love this color. End of discussion. A couple weeks later, she'd come back. You know, we really should paint this kitchen a different color. No, no. Why do you keep saying this? I like the bright, cheery, happy yellow. A week or two later, you know, I was thinking we could go down and get a couple Italian paintings or prints and hang them on the wall, and we could put a chair rail up and paint it white, and the top of the wall could be like a moss green. The bottom of the wall could be an olive green, and we'd have this little Italian-themed kitchen. And I went, oh, what? Can we do that now? Can we start now? Let's go get those things.
So the moral of the story is...
I'm easy to manipulate, and she figured out how to do it. And even though I knew it was happening, I didn't mind because she actually found a way to get me excited about it, right? And make me think, oh, I love this. So I think that's a great model for manipulating people, is if you can find the thing that they're interested in or the hook that would make them want it for themselves, then it's easy to get them to do what you want. And that's, again, how advertising works. It works on these kind of hidden motivations that we have. So,
but know. I'm sure advertisers don't know very much about me. They wouldn't know what they could talk about to make me motivated, would they?
Mm.
Where would they get that information?
Well... You are a weird cat, Tom, and yet, are you a carbon-based life form?
I think I am.
Yes. Well, there we go. That's enough knowledge already.
At the end of the rainbow, there's happiness, and to find it, how often I've tried, but my life is a race, just a wild goose chase, and my dreams have all been denied. Why have I always been a failure? What can the reason be? I wonder if the world's to blame. I wonder if it could be me. I'm always chasing rain.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. We've been talking about manipulation. why it's good, why it's the best thing for me, mm-hmm. how it's going to make my life better.
So how do you manipulate me, Tom?
That's classified.
I know one of the ways he manipulates me. Every time we go get food, he is rushing to pay for it, which has caused me to try to rush to pay for it before him. It's a really sneaky way to get me to pay.
It's the competition thing, you know? Competitiveness is something that you buy into. There was another time. I remember we were walking up a hill near my house. And I remember I started running up the hill. And you looked at it and you said, no way am I going to run up the hill like he's doing. Well, I ran by this sign that was like a little radar sign. So if you ran by with your arms up, it would tell you how fast you were running. So I ran by and it said like, 8 miles per hour because I was running up the hill. And he looked at me and said, I really don't want to run up this hill. But after seeing that, I got to run up this hill.
I have no memory of this, but I'm sure it's true. Did I win?
You might have. Yeah, I think you did.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings as time goes by. Moonlight and love song, never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's just the same old story. A fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. We've been talking about manipulation. And manipulation, I think it's been getting a bad rap. I think that people think that controlling other people, manipulating them is like a bad thing. Being controlled and being manipulated, they think that we should frown on that. We should be our own people and have our own thoughts and our own ideas.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, as if.
You get in trouble when you have that stuff. And I guess the truth of the matter is we never really have our own.
Exactly.
Opinions.
It's never your own idea. It's always built on all the things you've read, seen, watched, heard, thought before. So
I guess the question is, what's the best way to manipulate ourselves? How can I manipulate myself, Doug?
Well, first you get a sock.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. Thank you for joining us on this Manipulation Fest. We're talking about how important it is to manipulate each other and ourselves.
And you know what? You really love us and want to come listen to us again every chance you get. So go out to tomanddoug.com and buy all our merchandise and listen every week on your radio station.
Yes, and be here next week because we're going to be ready to do it to you again. Thank you so much for joining us.
Bye.
Here at the Tom and Doug Show, we invite you to watch how people react to the music.
The Tom and Doug Show remind you that you should see your doctor to get advice before listening to any other radio shows.
The Tom and Doug Show invites you to play something repetitive and hypnotic.
Repetitive and hypnotic, repetitive and hypnotic, repetitive and hypnotic.